to do our roll call?
He's on mute.
Kim?
You're on mute, Kim.
Kim.
Oh, I thought I didn't realize I was on.
You're muted.
I was talking before. It must have gone off. Okay. Commission Member Edelman.
Here.
Gross.
Here.
Kennedy.
Here.
Okay.
We're going to take under new business first our two guests. Paul will have you first and then Mark, because Paul, I believe you have two issues you submitted to us, a new hire and then an acknowledgement of a written employee warning. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, why don't we take the new hire first? Thank you for getting the write-up to us. Why don't you explain a little bit of his background? And we understand you had 9 candidates you looked at before you made the decision for the electrical instrumentational technician.
Right. Well, first, I want to acknowledge Tom Swansinger. He retired January 4th. We had actually advertised. He let us know end of November beginning of November that he was going to retire. So we started advertising at that time. Didn't have a lot of candidates actually apply. I don't know if that's because, you know, what the job market's doing out there, whether there's a lot of people that have jobs already or whether, you know, I'm not sure, but we usually get like 30 candidates. So I was kind of surprised at the.
I think people aren't making moves right now with COVID and all that. I think people are a little nervous about making moves.
Yeah. Plus, it was around the holidays, so, you know, that might have kept it down as well. But anyway, so we had a few qualified candidates. We interviewed them. Bill Patterson seemed to be the candidate that we all liked the best. We actually have interview questions that are geared towards technical, emotional intelligence, and just overall, you know, what their background is. And he scored the highest on that interview process. It's an electrical instrumentation technician, so this person kind of gets involved in troubleshooting a lot of our electrical panels, instrumentation, gets involved in PLC work, and also down at the plant, just because he's an EIT doesn't really mean that that's all he's going to be doing. It's kind of all hands on deck when we need people to clean out tanks, do painting projects, things like that. So we wanted to make sure that he was on board with, you know, doing that type of work as well. And he was very interested in getting a career job. He was currently working at Lincoln Electric. He got trained through Lincoln Electric for his electrical background, did training there, you know, hands-on and actually schooling. And like I said, when we ran him through the test questions, as far as, you know, his background knowledge, he was very knowledgeable on that. So we think he's going to work out very well.
Bob, Kelly, any questions?
I don't have any questions.
No.
With that, would somebody like to make a motion to approve this new hire?
I'll make the motion.
Okay, go ahead. I'll second that.
Okay, second. Everybody in favor, aye?
Aye.
Okay. Paul, good luck with your new employee. He looks like he's going to be a good candidate for you. And it's nice that hopefully he'll be here long haul, too.
Yes, thank you.
That's always a good sign.
Right.
We just want to make an acknowledgement. We don't make a motion or anything, but we've read the letter we received regarding the written employee warning. Since we're on Zoom, we just address this in a generic nature. Mm-hmm. But we read through it, and we saw that the employee did a nice job on the write-up in terms of the circumstances and what their corrective action that they wish to take.
Yes.
So I don't have any questions on that. We just acknowledge it on this call that we've received it and we've read through it.
Yeah, Kelly, Stan's an excellent employee. Just happened to be a victim of circumstance, and he was aware of what happened.
Well,
so we put things in place that hopefully it doesn't happen again.
Yeah, which I thought was very, very nicely done. Kelly or Bob, do you have any questions on that?
No questions.
I don't either.
Okay, Paul, you're good to go.
Okay, thank you very much. Nice meeting everybody.
All right.
Nice meeting you, Paul.
Bye.
Thanks, Paul. Take care.
All right, bye-bye.
Okay,
bye-bye.
Mark, you're up. We received your letter. Your memo dated January the 21st, part-time to full-time service worker, Tony Laparo. Do you want to give us, I read the background on this, is that full-time service worker position been an opening you've had, or you're moving them up? Maybe you can give us a little context on that.
Okay, yes, Tony's been with us since September of 19. He was actually, the last time I was at the committee, we had moved Mr. Pedicino, Nick Pedicino, from the same part-time to full-time. And I have to say, just as a side note, it's definitely the route that I like going. We get to see, you know, them as a part-timer, the whole, you know, 360 of them versus, you know, hiring full-time, how we do with the agility test and interviews. So I'm very happy and pleased with both of them. Tony was hired shortly after Nick, and he was going to be moved up to full-time early last year, but unfortunately the pandemic hit and we were at a hiring freeze at the time. But Tony is there. We did lose an employee, Tom Gibbs, last month. So Tony is replacing a existing position just to keep our numbers up, you know, especially during the wintertime for snow plowing, to make sure we have enough employees to cover our shifts during the weekdays and weekends. But Tony has just demonstrated, you know, he's an outstanding individual. He's very eager to learn. Tony also went ahead above and beyond. We do not require our part-time employees at all to get their CDLs. He took it upon himself to go ahead and do that in a part-time status, which I thought just showed his, you know, his dedication to want to work with us, because it's not something that's very, you know, easy to do. And just in addition to that, he's been working with us, like it said, since September 19. I had no issues with Tony whatsoever, other than the fact that he's just wanted to work as much as he can, and, you know, eventually become full-time. And I've always appreciated him sticking it out with us, especially through this the crazy last year we had and coming into this year. But Tony's, you know, he's been on our solid waste division. That's where we start our part-timers, as it's kind of an entry-level start to the department. But speaking with all of my managers, everyone has nothing but good things to say about Tony. So I definitely know that he will be a great addition in the full-time position for the service department. I just, nothing but good things to say about Tony, so.
Well, good, Mark, and thank you for the nice write-up too. And thank you for being here, because it allows us. So Bob or Kelly, do you have any questions on this movement from part-time to full-time?
I just want to make sure we have no issues with this. It's not typically a where we would require any type of competitive exams or tests or anything along those lines in this type of a role. Because part-time is a part-time.
Yeah, no, I don't believe so, because I believe it's classed under unskilled, Bob.
Okay.
And, you know, historically we've done that before too. And to Mark's point, when we've gotten them in part-time positions, we've been able to get a better gauge. It's almost like a test for several.
Understood. I just wanted to make sure that we're following the procedures for moving somebody up into a full-time role, that we don't have to go through any type of a competitive.
No, it's when I looked at it under section 4, I believe it designated that, because I looked under unskilled labor class and non-competitive class.
Okay.
So I think we're fine on that, especially I believe this is classed in unskilled labor class. What I would suggest is, can I have a motion to approve this move from part-time to full-time? Full-time service worker number 2.
I'll move to accept that move.
Okay, I'll second. All in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Mark, you're set to go.
Thank you. And I would just like to say a thank you to the committee. We did have our full-time mechanic hired last month under emergency. We've been through a lot with our mechanical department. With the loss of Frank Slowowski and then Steve Dahlhauser went out. I do apologize not being able to make it to the last meeting, but I do appreciate the committee's consent on that hire too as well. So thank you very much.
Well, Mark, we appreciate you giving us the background work written too, because we know you can't always make the meetings.
Well, thank you very much.
Thanks, you're welcome, Mark.
Good evening.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right. Let's get into it because we've got about 15, 20 minutes here and, you know, the rest is pretty straightforward. Did everybody have a chance to review the minutes for January the 20th?
Yep.
Yes.
Okay. Can I have a motion to approve those minutes?
I'll move to approve the minutes.
Bob?
I'll second it.
Kelly seconds. All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye. Okay, we had payroll for January the 15th. Did everybody have a chance to review that? I know it looked a little bit, perhaps there were a few hours there, but I think keeping in mind some of the holidays that have been incorporated in that, I know there's been some overtimes and a bit of a shift. So when I look through it, and also, you know, with service workers and snow plowing and those kind of things, so I'm fine with that. So can we have a motion to approve the January 15th and 29th payrolls?
I'll make the motion.
Okay, I'll second. All in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye. Kim, we didn't have any payroll change sheets, correct?
No, there were none.
Okay. So we hired the new we took care of the new business with our guests. Pending business on changes to rules and regulations. Bob, I know you were working on that last time. So
I don't have an update for you yet.
Okay. Well, obviously, you'll probably see Don at the upcoming patrolman's exam on the 14th. So you might take him aside for a few minutes.
Yeah, I think it'll be easier that way.
Yeah, you know, that might work out well for you.
So we'll social distance the resolution.
Yeah, we'll put a table between you two so we can do that. So we'll look forward to that on getting on board. Kim, why don't you give us a little update on the February 14th patrol officer's exam, and when we need to be there, and kind of where we're at with candidates?
Yep. The test is at 6 p.m., so I would need probably 5 by 5 p.m. to have everybody, whoever can make it, to help sign in. We are up to 100, and I think 115 candidates as of today for patrol officer. Deadline is Friday, so I kind of doubt that we'll reach, and I haven't gotten any more today. I had two early this morning, but I haven't gotten any more today.
Is there a maximum?
150.
Oh, 150. Okay.
Or yeah, 150. So we're at 115. Okay. Yeah. I mean, we'll probably get a few more stragglers, but I don't think we'll reach the 150. I'd be shocked.
Yeah, that's a big number.
But. Yeah, yeah. I accepted one payment. I got a call yesterday or Monday. I can't remember. From the city, a gentleman was there. He was having a hard time with the payment system, and he ran to City Hall, and they called me to see if he can accept, if they could accept his $20, and I said yes. And I'm glad I did, because then later on that evening, I went into the site, and I saw that he tried four times to pay, and I don't know if it was his credit card or whatever, but he's at least, you know, it's hard to say. It says canceled. It said it was canceled four times. So I did tell them they can accept his payment. And he was for corrections anyway. I think corrections, we have maybe 22 or 23.
Okay.
And corrections is on the 21st.
Yeah. 28. Well, no, we have 28 applicants.
28 applicants. Okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
What I asked Kim to do for the 14th, first of all, Bob and Kelly, you're both going to be there. So, especially with over 100 candidates, it just helps. So, are you okay with that?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, good. Kim's going to do three stations for us, and we're going to be in front of the community center because they're going to take those two back rooms. And Kim will float. I don't think we're going to have challenges with the paying system, because Ken and I talked today. We actually have that new paying system, which Ken, to your point, it's much more transparent for you to see about the payments.
Yes, I check them generally daily, but I actually found one who paid and put an application through, but we never got notification by email. So I've been checking, which I'm glad I checked. So I check every day now to make sure, and that was the only one.
Okay. All right. So I think with the three tables set up, she'll have it broken down alphabetically. It should be more straightforward, and we shouldn't have any residual or outlier questions about if they didn't pay. If they didn't pay, no play. So we'll just make that rule up front. We're not going to make any exceptions because the system now allows this. If there's an issue, Kim can address it immediately.
Right.
So if we're there by 5 o'clock at the front when you come in the doors, we should be good to go.
Yes.
All right. Any questions about the upcoming exams?
Oh, and then just so you know, I put on there that there's the physical agility exam, but we don't have to be there for that. I will go because I just sit there in case they have any questions, but the police department handles it all.
Okay. All right. That's good to know. And you'll give us an update on that once that's completed too.
Yeah. Yeah. I just go and sit in case, and you know, in case somebody comes out and has an issue with something.
Okay. All right. Any additions or changes to our agenda? Nope.
No, just no. If you want to select the March and April meeting dates, that's...
Oh, yeah, thank you, Kim. I'm moving ahead too fast here.
That's okay.
All right. Since we have a civil service meeting on February the 17th, if we do it every 2 weeks, on the March the 3rd, 17th, and 31st, the reason I want to do it every 2 weeks and we could do it via Zoom is just if there are any issues with the two tests. You know, we have to certify the list. We have to do things just so we could keep to this in a pretty timely manner. So is everybody okay with the 3rd, the 17th, and the 31st for March?
Yes.
Yeah.
17th is St. Patrick's Day.
Uh-oh.
Are you sure you're okay with that?
Yeah, I'm fine. Larry usually walks in the parade, but there was no parade last year.
There is no parade.
Won't be this year.
Unless Larry's going to have his own parade.
Yeah, he'll be around the yard doing what I tell him. So, yeah, I'm fine with that. 5:30. Now, I will make mention, as you saw in my email, we are getting our new director for HR. Depending on what's going on with COVID, if, you know, since she's coming on board at early March, maybe the 17th or the 31st, we might do a live meeting just so we could kind of meet her face to face, but it'll be socially distanced. But we'll see how things go. If not, she'll come on Zoom. Is that okay with everybody?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Okay.
So that was March 3rd and the 17th?
The 3rd, the 17th, and the 31st.
Oh, and the 31st. Okay.
That's every 2 weeks because we've got those two exams, Kim.
Okay.
And we have to certify the list, and we may have some people, as we all know, that dropped out of that because of the scrutiny given in terms of background checks and other thing going on. So that'll give us due diligence times. April, I looked at the 14th and the 28th.
It's okay with me.
Okay with me.
Okay by me.
Okay. Now, all these meetings are going to be Zoom until, you know, we can figure out what's going on. I think City Hall, Kim, is Is City Hall still closed, Kim?
Yes. They're staggering people. You know, in the departments, you know, some may work Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and the others work Tuesday, Thursday, and then they flap it the following week. So. All right.
So if we had an issue to do one of these meetings via live, we just have to give advance notice to Solon?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Right now, I'm not voting for going in live unless we absolutely have to. Is that everybody's in agreement? We've done a good job by email and everything mm-hmm. else going on. So I don't think Kim will do that unless there's an issue or something.
Okay.
Plus, we'll be seeing one another at the two sessions, at least the 14th. Everybody will be there. The 21st, we may not need everybody because it's only 28 people. But we'll cross that bridge because on the 17th, we could discuss it.
Yeah.
All right. I think, does anybody have anything else for the good of the order?
Nothing here.
No.
Okay, then I think we're out, and we'll see you then coming up on the 14th. That'll be here before we know it. Stay warm. It's supposed to be a very cold weekend.
Yeah, that's for sure.
You know, that's going to be... Mark said, though, they're going to start putting this stuff on the streets tonight. I guess they have a special kind of formulation. So hopefully the ice will be prevented some ways before we get out here too far. All right, Kelly, Bob, thank you for your time this evening.
Thank you.
And we'll see you on the 14th.
Sounds good.
Sounds
okay,
good.
That's good. Thanks, guys.
Thanks. I'm going to move to adjourn. We got to move to adjourn, by the way.
I'm out of here. Thank you, Bob. Can I have a motion? I'll make the motion to adjourn, Bob.
Okay, there you go.
I'll make the motion. Can I have a second?
All right, fine.
Bob will second. All in favor, aye.
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 Bob, thank you for keeping me on the straight and narrow here. I was so excited we were
it's
getting...
Like it's a full-time job.
Yeah, I know. Talk to Larry.
Larry called me.
Yeah. I'm sure he's thought about it. Especially with COVID. All right.